circuit from a 60 Hz square wave oscillator with an output level on TTL logic. In fact, it's a very simple circuit, a combination from three circuits. Here we have the sine wave oscillator. Now in the middle of the screen, the buffer stage. And here a logic chip. It is a 7490 and it is a divider by 10. Because of the fact that these oscillators, one transistor oscillators, don't work good on frequencies lower than 300 Hz, the best idea is to let it oscillate on 600 Hz and divide that that frequency by 10, and that's done here. Here inside we have a buffer stage that changes the output voltage from this circuit to logic level, and that is 0 and 1 between approximately 0 and 5 volts. That's not completely the logic levels. Anyway, you can search that in books. Here the chip. This capacitor proved to be for stability 50 picofarad, otherwise the chip was had a kind of hiccup. Here we have a resistor, that's a variable resistor RX, and that can be between 47k and 100k, and for experiments use a potmeter from 1 mega ohm. The function from that diode and that potentiometer is to set the time relation in the frequency from the square wave a little bit, but I found out that I had 600 Hz here and here approximately 60 Hz. And it's only meant to fine-tune the waveform. The circuit is furthermore classical. You can also go to 50 Hz. When you bridge, for instance, all these three capacitors by 10 nanofarad, and perhaps you can get that then with that fine-tuning here to 50 Hz, and to change between 50 Hz and 60 Hz, you have to do some experiments with the values from these two resistors and or the value from these two capacitors. You can get to other frequencies. The power supply is very classical. It's here a series regulator that produces 5 volts, and here is the 10 volts that goes directly from this location to this location. So I show the circuit another time in its completeness, and then we go to the breadboard. Here is the breadboard with the circuit. This is the 7490 chip. It's a low Schottky TTL chip, and here the LED, here is the output that goes to the scope and the counter. Here we see the sine wave oscillator with the different capacitors. Here the potentiometer for fine-tuning, 1K. And the buffer chip is not very good visible, but anyway, it's there. Supplied by 10 volts. Also works on 12 volt, and here you can see what happens. This is the input to the frequency divider. This is the output, 10 times lower. This is the actual frequency at the output. And when you turn the potentiometer somewhat, the 1K, in the phase shifting network, you can tune in a little bit and fine-tune it to 60 hertz approximately. I think the stability is quite good, and use for capacitors plastic capacitors, no ceramics. Ceramics are too frequency too sensitive for temperature changes. So foil capacitors work best. And perhaps you can also use, to get 5 volt for this chip, a 7805. I did not do that experiment. I found that 7805 sometimes doesn't work. That's the reason why I used a classical series regulator.